that is the motors, that is in the model 5. So we'll be completing the special motors. So that is I think universal motor and AC servo motor, it has been completed the last class. So now we'll go for doing the another two other motors, that is the special motors. There is linear induction motor and stepper motor. Okay, well, coming for the stepper motor, so here we can see the construction of a stepper motor. So how it will be looking, so where it will be used, and what is the advantage and disadvantage, so that we'll see with respect to the stepper motor. Okay, so generally it is an electromechanical device, so which will be converting from electrical energy to the mechanical energy, and it is a brushless electric motor. Okay, and it has been divided in two subdivisions. So one will be the full rotation, that is depending upon the pulses. Okay, so half is there and full it is there. Okay, so based on these two categories, okay, we can go for the step count also. Okay, so it depends upon the 8 pole or 12 poles or 16 poles, like that. Okay, the motor positions can be controlled accurately without any feedback mechanism. So that is the another advantage with respect to this stepper motor. Okay, and also I think in your PE lab, when you come for next semester, so there we will see the a stepper motor, so which will be used for half cycle as well as the full cycle. And actually when we go for the practical application, there will be some error. Okay, so that is in terms of 1% error we will be getting. So, but still it will be operating exactly at a accurate analysis. Okay, so that's the advantage of the stepper motor. Okay, so generally the stepper motor is similar to that of switched reluctance motor. Okay, so a stepper motor can be operated, that is for it will be having the magnets to make the motor shaft turn in a precise distance, that is with respect to accurate positions. Okay, the stator, if you see with respect to the diagram, so it consists of 8 poles and the rotor consists of 6 poles, so with 24 pulses of electricity to move in 24 steps. Okay, so that will be one complete revolution when we go for 24 pulses. Okay, so another way, if you go in terms of degrees, so previously it will consider 15 degrees for each pulse. Okay, so that is the another thing. So here you can see the construction of a stepper motor. Okay, so here is the rotor, which consists of 6 poles. Okay, so which will be represented as AA dash, BB dash and C dash. Okay, so now with respect to this, the rotor is actually having windings which is being wound on the poles, that is the commutator will also come into consideration. And the stator is made up of multipoles and multi-phase windings, so 3 or 4 phases winding as the requirement. Okay, and angular displacement as per the input pulses. Okay, so that's how the stator and the rotor will be coming into consideration. So while coming to the working, the stepper motor works on the principle of electromagnetism, where the supply has been given to the stator. So therefore the magnet rotate shaft in surrounding to the magnetic electromagnetism of the stator. Okay, the rotor and the stator has the n number of poles. So based on the design, so whenever the stator is energized, the rotor, it moves to align itself with respect to the stator. Okay, that is the stator when it has been energized. So with respect to the different poles, the rotor will be rotated in steps. So that's why we will call it as a stepper motor. Okay, so that is the working of stepper motor. So while coming to the speed, rotation and control, so it is having a good control. So the speed also, it is not much having a high speed. Okay, so generally it has been programmed. Okay, so based on the number of cycles and the rotations, so it will complete within that particular time period. Okay, so generally if you go for the application point of view, it has been used in industries like CNC machines, robotics. Okay, so in case of automation and instrumentations, so there we are using this type of motors. Okay, so when you go for the types of stepper motor, so variable reluctance stepper motor is there, the permanent magnet stepper motor is there, hybrid stepper motor is there. So for various applications, we'll be going for different types of motor. Okay, so if you see the advantages, the rotation angle is proportional to the input pulses. So whatever the input pulses we are giving, so exactly it will take that particular position. So if I give the value as one pulse, exactly it will take one pulse. But practically if we see, so there will be a slight change. Okay, so as I told, there will be 1% error. Okay, not more than 1%. That means 0.01 or 0.001 you will be getting as the error. Okay, so the full torque is been standstill at the full torque will be applied at the standstill. So the next very low speed synchronization rotation is possible and there is no brushes, so it is reliable. Speed is directly proportional to the frequency of the input as the pulse has been given. So based on the pulse, the speed will be directly proportional. So hence the wide range of rotational speed can be realized. Okay, so low speed with high precision can be executed. So these are some of the advantages. So coming to disadvantages, there is no feedback system. The efficiency is low. Noise is not much noise. So if I go for, that is based on the application point of view and based on the size. Okay, if you go for a higher size, then the noise will be more. For small motors, the noise is less. Okay, so as he is telling, more produces more noise, may produce more noise. So based on the size of the machine. Okay, so difficult to operate at very high speed, and smooth move, micro stepping is required. Okay, as I told, it will not move very fast, so it has to move in steps. So these are some of the disadvantages, the drawbacks with respect to the stepper motor. So application point of view, it can be used in industrial machineries like automotive machine tooling, so automated production equipments. So I'll come into the security, new surveillance products for security industry. So in case of medical, stepper motors are used inside medical scanners. Okay, so samplers, and also in case of photography, that is inside digital dental photography, fluid pumps, respiratory blood analysis. So like that in medical, the stepper motor has been used. And in case of consumer electronics, stepper motors in cameras for automatic digital camera focus and zoom. So there we are using the stepper motors. So not only there, in case of printer printing machines, okay, in the printers, so there we can see some stepper more applications of the stepper motor. Okay, so these are some of the industrial applications. So still, if you go in case of factory automation, packing, material handling, aerospace industry, so 3D print pictures. So there we can we are using the stepper laser measurements. There we are using the stepper motors. So this is regarding the stepper motor. So working and applications, advantages and disadvantages of stepper motor. So next comes the linear induction motor. So again here the linear induction motor, again it consists of the stator part and the rotor part. So it is a asynchronous motor. So working on the principle of as usual, the as the induction motor. Okay. So here you can see there is a stator and the rotor. So which the way the connector is being made up of copper or aluminium. So I'll come into the construction. The stator is cut axially and spread. So this is the when we go for cut and view. So that is a straight line where the three windings is being wound on the stator frame. Okay, so linear induction motor. So where the stator and rotor are the primary and secondary coils. Okay, the secondary of the linear induction motor consists of flat aluminium conductor with a ferromagnetic core. So here we can consider it as AB and make it flat, then the stator will look in this form. Okay, when we cut the stator and if we make it flat, so this is how the stator will be looking. Similarly, when we go for the secondary, so here we can see the secondary, which is nothing but the aluminium bar, that is the blue strip. So the primary of linear induction motor is flat and three phase winding is been wound on it. Okay, now the while coming to the rotor, so again the rotor is been made flat with that is the aluminium conductors, which is called as the secondary windings of a linear induction motor. Okay, so this is the diagram how we can represent the stator and the rotor when it has been cut and when it has been stretched in the flat surface. So coming to the working, as usual, so when the supply has been given to the stator, the rotating flux has been produced. So as the flux produced in the rotor links in the stator links in the rotor with the synchronous speed, which is similar to the three phase induction motor type. Okay, so when the magnetic flux links, a current will be generated in the rotor conductors, that is in the aluminium material in the secondary of a linear induction motor. Okay, so this current in the secondary winding interacts and the flux has been produced, so which is nothing but IDL into B, so that is BI into L. Okay, so L is the difference with respect to the length of the conductor, and based on the design, okay, so either the primary can be fixed and is secondary can be mobile, or if secondary is fixed and the primary is free to move. Okay, so we can go for any option. So with respect to this, the working principle is similar to the double gauge induction motor, that is a double linear induction motor. So if I go for the double linear induction motor, you can see the construction, how it will be performing. Okay, so here is the secondary at the top, and here is the primary winding will be at the bottom. Okay, the linear synchronous speed traveling wave. So that is equation we can give as Vs is equal to 2 into f into pole pitch. So meters per second. So where f is the frequency, that is a supply frequency in hertz. When the rotor of an induction motor has been rotated, that is the speed of a secondary in a linear induction motor, which will be less than that of the synchronous speed. Okay, that is Vs. So then we can represent the rotor speed will be equal to Vs into 1 minus s. So if I combine these two, that is the difference with respect to synchronous and the rotor speed. So we can find this step. So step is equal to Vs minus Vr divided by Vs. So it will be in terms of per unit. So the linear force by an induction motor can be given as F is equal to air gap power divided by linear synchronous velocity, that is Vs. So Vs is equal to 2F into the pole pitch. Okay, this is the Vs formula. So thus, when we go for the torque and speed characteristic of a linear induction motor, so this is how it will be looking. So initially during the starting, it will be having it is a starting torque, and the maximum torque will be increased when the step is at the maximum. Okay, so that condition we know what we have seen in our derivation in induction motor. Okay, so this is the top speed curve which can be represented for the linear induction motor. So while coming to the linear induction motor, if a rotor induction motor is compared with a linear induction motor, that is a rotary, the linear induction motor requires large air gap, and hence the magnetizing current is greater and the power factor and efficiency of the motor are low. So the rotor induction motor and the stator area will be same. So whereas in case of linear induction motor, one of the two is less. Okay, so at the steady speed, the shorter part will be passing continuously over the new part of the other members. Okay, so generally, so while coming for the application of linear induction motor, so it can be used in case of cranes, so pumping of liquid metals, actuators, that is opening the automatic doors. Okay, so used in high voltage, that is circuit breakers, and also in accelerators. Okay, so this is regarding the applications of linear induction motor. Okay, do you have any doubts? Any doubts? If we don't have any doubts, I'll wind up the session.